Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to Rise of the Tomb Raider. We're here in the middle of the Guardian's Path, really. It's where the Guardians all hang out. You know, when you're immortal, don't really have much to do. You all hang together. Or you hang separately. That was supposed to be a reference to Benjamin Franklin, but I don't think I actually pulled it off. So there's going to be a lot of guys here. This kind of reminds me of the other game, Tomb Raider, from 2012, 2014, I don't know, 20-something, anyway. Reminds me of the last game, kind of towards the climax, where we did something very similar to this. We kind of breached the Immortal Guardian's defenses. I do want to get up there, I just don't know if it's possible. We did kill some guy. Okay, or cutscene, hello. Yeah, sure, why not, Akina, why not? Suppose you guys will react well to poison. Okay, they like their Greek fire. Poison could actually work pretty well on these guys. Or explosions. Oh, okay. Also the possibility. Alright, detonated two of them. They don't like me cheating, I guess. I mean, that's fair. I did cheat. I did just heal, too. Hey, guys. Okay, that was definitely more explosions than I thought was going to happen. Just gotta wait for the Byzantine fire to go away and we're good. Or he has more friends? No, that was just the fire breaking down the area there. Alright, make sure there's nothing else in the area we want to get. There are some packs here from the vaporized guys. Vaporizing your enemy is always kind of weird. Don't really, not a big fan of it. Generally, because it just raises a lot of questions, you know? These guys were immortal, what exactly happens to them? I mean, clearly, I mean, the source, Jacob says, is not divine. So, I mean, immortal souls might not be an actual thing. But immortality almost was. These guys lived for, like, you know, 1800 years. Just basically reducing them to ash just by hitting them a lot. Why doesn't Jacob react the same way? Well, because he's a prophet. It's not the way it works. Apparently I need some herbs. I should pick those up. Pick this up. Oh, more Mongolian.
We observe something strange in the night. We are camped above the city of Gutesh as the city prepares for invasion. They still believe the attack will come from on high. They will not expect your charge from the paths on the far side of the valley. But I must tell you, on the tower at the heart of the city, something unnatural awaits us. We watched hundreds of armored soldiers ascend its heights, and then a light cracked the sky. There was a sound that froze my blood, a roaring like an army of hungry ghosts. Then the men descended again. I do not know what they keep atop that tower. We thought it a treasure, but it appears to be something else entirely.
Okay, so that's the usage of the divine source, no doubt, to make the army invincible. Although they seem to be slightly less so nowadays, so the invincibility does have limits. Sure, why not? I'll open this up. And an actual relic.
This is, particularly odd. Has elements of Scythian design, but it looks like a... not possible.
Looks like a what? You have to clue me in here. Looks like a what? Early inhabitants. Mysterious figurine of what, though? Was it supposed to... Okay. I mean, not being privy to her thoughts is a little bit frustrating in that instance. Alright. Looks like a no, not possible. There's another thing over here. Like another document. It's wireless survival mode. This perk should really work out for us.
We have sealed the doors and barred them from entry. The riders are coming, and I must keep these people safe. Mothers with children, old men like me, those that cannot fight. I have food and water in sufficient quantities to keep us alive for the length of the attack. Should our Athanatoi fail, and the attack becomes a siege, we will die here. For that, I have enough Belladonna to provide the little ones with safe passage. Pray it never comes to that.
So, typically with belladonna, you would put it into a tea, but from what I understand, that is not a peaceful way to go. I might be misunderstanding. It could be just lure you into a bad sleep, but I'm not actually sure. It's okay, this is obviously a way down, not up. Don't see a way to get up from here. Alright, so we can ignore that, and I guess move through the very obvious no way. No. No. Okay. There's gotta be another way. I didn't see a way this way. Is there another way? There's gotta be. The steps kind of indicate there is. Alright, so there's already a rope here. Oh, okay, so I just didn't go far enough. Totally my bad. Alright. Okay, so this is easy. I thought for sure we were supposed to jump down into the river, which I didn't even know how that's going to work. Okay, so that's our way back, in case we want it. If we do. Okay, another practice slide through here, so I'm expecting breaking in. That's probably pretty appropriate, actually. The Guardians definitely don't appreciate we're here. I'm kind of surprised we can kill them, though. I was really expecting that Trinity soldiers would be here first. Alright, we can do this. This is just a matter of a jump, then a rope climb, and then another jump, and that should be fine. Let's do it. And boing. We did it. Oh, okay. That was much farther than I thought we were gonna go. Or two, apparently. Oh, alright. Apparently he didn't survive the fall either. She didn't break her arm, did she? No, alright. Okay, well, we're in Lost City. This is Katesh proper, I think. This is basically the surviving elements after the Mongol invasion.
Lara!
The radio still works?
They're going to break through the ice any minute.
Do you think you can stop them?
The best we can do is buy you some time. I'll see you on the other side.
Yeah, I think she's got to go for it now. They're about to break through the ice. We don't really have a choice. Has to happen now. Alright, I mean, that guy's cool. Nice design overall. I could use more explosive. Yeah, there we go. We haven't actually used any of the poison ones yet, because I wasn't sure it was going to work.
The Chamber of Souls. The Divine Source has to be there.
I don't know, is that the tower that they were talking about before?
Looks where are the like guardians? The way into the city center is through that gate.
Alright, get through the gate then. Obviously it's not going to be a direct approach. We leveled up, right? Should make sure.
I don't know what I expected an immortal being to be like, but Jacob seems so human. The things he must have seen over the years, all that experience and knowledge, it's difficult to fathom. And yet, he lied to his own people for generations, all for the sake of this secret. What wonders will be unlocked with the Divine Source? Will humans finally understand the true nature of the soul? Or will it unlock some extraordinary new scientific discovery? One thing is certain. It's too important to allow Trinity to control.
Increasing the rate of fire would be nice. I suppose we could do it, but that costs us all of our hides. What else can we do? Yeah, it's not Moonshot, that is the upgrade, so I'm not going to worry about it. No damage upgrades, so really, if I can't do any more damage upgrades, I don't really care. Yeah, padded grip's okay. I think upgrading the military rifle might be my best idea here. And boosting the reload speed might be. So I got the headshot indicator only because I mentioned it last episode. Just because it seems like maybe it's going to be useful. But I don't know. We'll see. So it looks like we're just supposed to jump right into it here. Alright, let's do it. Okay, this looks like another one of the pyres I need to light. But sadly, not an option from here. Sure, I'll pick that up.
The Deathless are patrolling the streets. got to stay out of sight.
Yeah, avoiding them seems like the ideal, right? Because how else are you supposed to fight an immortal being if they're actually truly immortal? Okay, looks like there's a lot of different ways to go here. Could, of course, just... Why do we want to take that out? Maybe to make a distraction? Yeah, I mean, I'd love to take the mural here. I don't know if it's actually possible. It's tactical roll into an industry spot. That's the only guy, though, that might be doable. You have healing herbs, too. Oops, that's not the roll I wanted to make, but it happened anyway. Oh, yeah, he saw me. Where are you? There you are. Man, that took a lot of damage. Okay, that was not... He said he'd give up. I don't think that's what he actually said, though. Okay. So that was not sneaky at all. Oh, should not have done that. If I'd do that over again, I probably wouldn't do it.
Incredible. The style looks ancient, but it depicts a train. The coming of the Soviets.
Well, that's funny. It makes sense they'd keep tabs on the outside world, right? Okay, well, I mean, if we're gonna do this the hard way... So we can apparently hit the bell. Why would you want to? I don't know. So there's another pyre to light up. Maybe if you want to, like, distract them or something. Yeah, like, that's hanging there. I wonder if you can light that on fire. You can light it on fire, and it does drop. Then it turns out to be supplies. Yeah, that's exactly right. Okay. One whole supply. So how do you light that pyre up? That's a good question. I mean, we don't know how many of these guys. Oh, this is probably another challenge. No? Another challenge? That's something we're supposed to be able to hit, maybe. I don't know. Let's try it. Fire. Yep, shoot down all the deathless banners. Okay, so that is actually a thing. Okay. So that's another challenge in this area. Alright, she's acting all sneaky, so this is definitely a spot where we're supposed to be at least a little stealthy. Or maybe we just take out the deathless. I mean, that's also a thing. Apparently not actually deathless. Totally misnamed. Okay, there's some soldiers here. How do you want to do this? I mean, really, it seems like poison or explosions might work out well here. They're not really looking for me. They're just patrolling because that's what they do. I mean, they can totally all see each other. Oh, no, they can't. No, they can't. Trick is going to be how we're going to do this. So I could, if I was in a different position, this would be a lot easier. What would be a better position to be in? Over that way? Far, far away? Far, far away or up would work. Up would definitely work. How do we get up? Yeah, see, they're not really spotting each other at all. I'll wait till this guy goes... Thing is, with their masks, I don't know if they're actually susceptible to poison. Kind of seem like, but oh yeah, yep, they're susceptible to poison. All right, but that alerted all of them. Now you're gonna be looking around for me. Fortunately, maybe not have been. And great stealth bonus? Possibly not. But hey, wasn't worked. We got a bunch of arrows and a bunch of rifle ammo. And a bunch of hides. So this might be the only way up? No, probably not actually meant to be a way up. Okay, how do we light these pyres? We're supposed to be alerting them of Trinity's attack here. There's a pyre up there. Isn't there a pyre over here, too? thought there was. Oh, yeah, there it is, up there. I just can barely see it. Well, I might be able to get up this way. So if I go over to this side, and I don't know. Nope, that did not work. Fortunately, there's only water there. So it really looks like I'm supposed to be up higher to make that work. How does that work? Or I could slide down from there. Okay. That seems more reasonable. So I'm not sure how else it's supposed to work. I think that's more the way back rather than the way forward. This ice is probably not going to hold me, right? No? It's not holds. All the way around, maybe? I mean, I'm not being sneaky at all. Definitely taking out all the deaths as I can go, and that's probably actually going to hurt their defenses, if anything. I can slide down, but how do I get up? That's what I really want to do. So... yeah, I mean, I want to slide down this one. Obviously, that's not going to happen. Slide down that one, that just takes me back to where I was. Slide down this one, that takes me to technically a new spot. But not really where I want to be either. I don't like this freaking pyres. That pyre too. I mean, I could try to switch to fire arrows. It doesn't look like that works. Yeah, it doesn't actually work. Okay, well, there's scratch marks there, right? Any broadhead arrows? No. Why is there a... I don't know. Anyway, that's a path we'll go up. Okay, we can try it. I don't exactly know how that works unless we can, I don't know, wall walk or something? Is that actually a thing we can do? I really doubt it. Now, this looks like that's a jump you're supposed to make from there to there. Otherwise, I mean, we can light this on fire. Does that actually do anything? Not from here. I thought maybe it was cloth there, but it might just be something I need to use a shotgun on. Okay, so that didn't work. I don't think there's any more guys here. I think we've actually taken out all the Deathless. Hurry up. There's gotta be a way to go off. See, that rope takes me to where I want to go, not where I want to come back from. The only way I think I can get up there is from another rope, right? Unless I'm missing something. Actually, there might be... that might be climbable here. Not according to survival mode, no. Alright, let's go down then. I'm not sure what the alternative is here. I mean, sure, give me more salvage. Can always use more salvage. Is there something inside this building? I think so. Also rats. Dude, you guys live here. Have you no, like, sense of, I don't know, propriety or something? I'm gonna burn my way into here. Maybe they just haven't lived here in a while. They just live in the barracks, nowhere else. Now, this is where things used to be, but could be they've decided that this is all civilian housing and so no one deserves to live here anymore. Weird, but not totally foreign. I mean, it is a valid point. Alright, is there anything around here? Like a strong box? Oh no, there's been the dude. He's seen by... oh, okay, so there's a bunch of guys there. Oh, we can make poison here. That takes out both of them. Nobody even saw it happen. Why am I bouncing around here? That's a good question. Because there's something that I want, I guess? Okay. It's a good swing, and it worked. Oh. It's only salvage. Okay. There's another thing there, which I guess I can use with explosives, right? There you go. So that'll theoretically get me in there. Whether or not that's a good thing, I don't know. More of this stuff. Oh, and Mongolian? Mongolian.
I have made myself a refuge in this frozen hell. in the base of a crumbling tower. I have laid away food and weapons enough to defend myself. But I am the last survivor. By day, I watch the Deathless Army, learn the paths they take. They follow the same patterns, day in and day out, like men trapped in a dream. They are fierce, but they are hollow. Whatever made them men is long gone, replaced instead by a soul of cold iron. I must be careful, but I must know more about them. If this is what the Source can do in the hands of a heretic, think of what it could do in the hands of the righteous.
Huh. So you can make them immortal, but they lose what makes them human. Okay, that's quite the price to pay. So maybe not as good as we originally thought. That's too bad. They're always just going to be a price. Yeah, I don't think that would be worth it then. If I'm not myself, then am I really mortal then? Fair point. We need fire instead. There you go. They've definitely sealed off all these places, so apparently they just work off of whatever the last orders they were given were. That's it. Okay, what's the relic we have?
A woman's necklace, made of Baltic amber. Incredible craftsmanship. It must have belonged to a noblewoman.
And that's where you get surprised, right? No, it turns out this is just peasant wear. Everyone used to wear stuff like this. It's possible. I only did that so I could pick up the items. So, I don't know how to light these fires. So I might just leave it be for now, because I don't know how else we're going to get up here. So, there's another chest over there that might hold a relic, or might hold nothing. So, it could just be, you know, inventory. Let's see. It's right here. It is another relic. What do you know?
These are spurs from Mongol horsemen. They're far more decorative and lavish than I'd expect. But they're still well used. Whoever owned them was wealthy, but they rode with the army.
Probably gold-plated rather than actually gold.
They're stables. Nothing but bones, picked clean.
And quite a few dead. Do the Deathless need to eat? And there's hay here. But I don't see how they could possibly have farmed, like, anything. There's no room for it. Alright, I think we need to climb up. Yeah, towards there. Alright. That's why we go up here. I really like to light these pyres, though. Can barely even... Okay, I can see that one. Oh, okay. They know we're here. And that's a trebuchet. On the upside, they're destroying their own work, so you just need to wait for the rest of it to go away.
They're firing at me.
You can use the trebuchet to destroy gates. I can, or they can.
To break through that gate.
Oh, hello. Oh, wow, hello. And you're out. And if you're no longer human, I don't feel as bad taking you guys out anymore. Heal up. There you go. Okay, so where are we supposed to go? Let's go that way. I don't believe you. Well, I mean, I believe you, but I don't believe that I believe you. If you know what I mean? Yeah, pick some of that up. And they don't necessarily know where I am, right? Because they have amazing tracking abilities, which I guess is possible. Right, that goes back to where we were. Don't go that way. We want to go towards the trebuchet so that we can use it. Another relic. Alright, sure, why not? Just in the middle
There's
of a giant
a piece
fight.
There's a flint in the pouch. It's a striker to start a fire. Each Mongol soldier had to be self-sufficient.
So they were just taking prizes from each one of their conquered, huh? Okay, no, I did light him on fire. It just took a while to actually take. I was wondering if the fire was actually doing anything. Alright, and they could blow up the Greek fire there, so don't stay here for too long. And looks like straight jump up. And they are kind of aiming towards me, but it does take time to re-aim a trebuchet, I would hope. And they're dedicating soldiers to go behind me, which I appreciate. Okay, up we go. Up we go. And they're probably going to be firing a lot at me. They're probably actually expecting me to take these guys out now. Okay, so I couldn't go up there before because it wasn't time. Oh, I'm out. Okay, fire arrow. There you go. Burn him alive. There we go. Thank you. Much appreciated. Your stuff. Okay, so how are we supposed to get over here? Oh, it's definitely the broadside arrows. Yeah, so these weren't here before. This way. There you go. Maybe even heal yourself up a little bit? No? Can't do it here? Alright. Never mind then. Unfortunately, anything they give me here will be not worth it. How do I get up? How do I get up? Bounce? No bounce. How do I get up here? Oh, alright, that's actually super simple. Didn't even expect it to be on this side. So, okay, I was wondering how to light these things, and it turns out it's going to be totally easy. You're on fire. I don't think you know that, but you are on fire. And he's out. Find some cover. Okay, that didn't actually work out very well. Okay, you're on fire now. Oh, so am I. Touché. Touché. Come on, you're still on fire, though. You know you're still on fire? I don't think he knows this one. Come on, hit him again. Hit him again. I wish I could lock onto these guys. There we go. Oh, man. Arrow right through the freaking soft palate there. She's still crouched. There's still bad guys about. Oh, it's probably because they're men in the trebuchet, right? I can re-aim it, probably by doing something here. More than likely, we're supposed to go up. So, how do we go up from here? Bounce? Seems logical. Oh, hello. Oh, yeah, yeah. Everyone likes that move. I can knock away your armor. And then you're not so much alive. Alright. She's still down. Is there still somebody here? No.
Got to break down that gate.
And we could do that. What I really want to do, though, is aim for that, because I'm pretty sure this is how we're going to light these fires. It's by using the trebuchet. So, can I arm the trebuchet? Seems like it's got to be possible. I don't know if it's meant to be used by one person, but we can try it. Okay, so what I want to do is move it towards... I'm going to assume this is going to point where we're going to fire. And then we want to launch it, which I'm assuming is going to be this side. Or not.
Looks like I can line up a shot on that gate.
Maybe we need to line up a shot on the gate first, and then we can move the trebuchet wherever we want. I have a feeling once we line this up, it's going to be it. But we can do it. Sure. Other way. Sorry. There you go. It's usually how it works.
That's good enough. Now to fire.
Okay. Okay. Hold right trigger. How does that... Okay. Sure, why not? There we go. Bombs away! Oh yeah, what do you know? Opened it right up. Okay, so if it's that easy, we should be able to move... We can still move this. This is totally how we're supposed to do this. Okay. So we just need to... There's also another trebuchet there, in case you want one. Looks like we can, like, right around there. That should do it. Right trigger. Yes, that's it. Right there. So that'll light that one, theoretically. There you go. Burn, baby, burn. That's one signal tower. There looks like there's also another one over here. And the trebuchet should totally be able to make that, right? So I mean, it turns around 360 degrees. I hope it does. A little bit more. A little bit. There you go. That should be good enough. There you go. Good enough. Bombs away! I really do like this. Super cool. 2 of 5. So that means there's more, obviously. Alright, let's turn around this way. I know we have one more that I can see. There must be another one. I mean, there's another trebuchet, like, directly in front of us, so maybe we need to get up there. There's another trebuchet there. Oh no, there's two. I don't know if that far one is actually reachable. Maybe not this one. We'll see. Yeah, there we go. That's totally reachable. But yeah, I don't think the other one is. Not from here. But yeah, it does look like there's another trebuchet. We should be able to get to it if I go through the gate. Alright, one more. One more from here. Go back the other way. It's always the fifth one that's the trouble. It's usually how these games work, is it's always going to be the fifth one that causes you the most trouble. Well, the last one, really. Never the fifth, but always the last. There you go. Okay. Yeah, there's no way we're hitting the last one from here, but there is another trebuchet, I believe, right there. And that should totally be able to hit that one. Unless we light it up from some other way, which is possible. Okay. Bon voyage. Straight to the gate, which should be no problem because there's nobody even waiting for us anymore. Oh, we should be able to use the rope, right? Can we use the rope here? Ream it somewhere else? Oh, she's bent over. Who's here? Who's here? I don't see anybody. There were a couple of guys that went down this way, though. I don't think we got them all. So it's very likely there's somebody else here that I don't know. Wouldn't be able to tell. Alright, don't see anybody though. Looks like we're free and clear. Of course, now we're in trouble, right? New base camp, like that. Don't think we have. We can look to see if we have a skill point. We do not.
Before I even held you, I almost lost you, Lara. Yet you fought back, determined to live, breathe, ball your tiny fists, and scream the hospital down. It was the best noise I ever heard. When I went home that snowy night, I cooked myself a steak. Then I drank half a bottle of whiskey, tried to make snowshoes out of tennis rackets, and fell asleep with the cat. I was so damn happy.
What?
I think I must have heard that story about a dozen times, and I could hear it a dozen more.
He tried to make...
I wish that could have lasted.
He tried to... What?
I wish we'd had more time.
You know, if he hadn't committed suicide, he totally would have. But, you know, I realize it's a sore spot for you, but still. Alright. Might as well make the military rifle as good as we can get it. I don't think we're going to be able to fully upgrade it, but that'll at least help a little bit. Alright, where are we supposed to go? What are we supposed to do? Something with these statues. Maybe we're supposed to knock these down. Maybe that's, like, one of the challenges. Yep. Destroy all the headless statues. Okay. Didn't realize that was a thing. So it looks like aiming for the legs is probably the best way to do it. Alright, well, we know where more of those are, but I'm not going to go back for it right now. I realize we do get bonuses for the bonus experience.
There's been some structural damage. The battle certainly took its toll. But most of the city is still standing.
So with these, oh, there's another mural. With those, I don't know if you can knock them down with a shotgun blast, you have to wait for a rope on the other side.
This mural commemorates the dead lost in the battle, and those that died after of disease and starvation.
Right, because it wasn't just the army in here, it was also the surviving citizens. However few those might have been. Don't want to go down that way. Well, yeah, City Buried Nice is probably an appropriate moniker for this, because this is definitely pretty buried. Alright, well, they clearly want me to go that way, it's just that there's a trebuchet somewhere. I need to go around for the trebuchet. So let's try to knock down this and see if we can, at least. Not with this gun. Let's try the shotgun. Nope, no such luck. We could try Grab me some of those. Try explosive arrows, but this doesn't look like the right kind of barrier to be taken around by explosives. This looks like it might be, yeah, it's rope on the other side. Alright. So you can only take it down with rope. Alright, we might have to just have to loop. Not from here, though. That is a straight trip to hell, is what that is. Cold hell, too. Turns out hell has frozen over. Alright, well, sure, we'll slide over here. It's gotta be an ambush, right? The arrows would signify yes. And this guy looks Mongolian, so... Okay, we have new arrows. Armor piercing. Oh. Can't imagine you have very many of those. Survive the ambush. Alright. Automatically upgrades silent arrows, so this just automatically happens. Okay. How do they know I'm here? Did explode some stuff? Heal up. Oh, look, more guys. Oh, wow, that worked. Oh, that's right, I have cluster bombs, don't I? That worked out nicely, actually. How are you alive? Be dead. Be dead. Scramble, scramble, scramble. Scramble. I need to scramble, like, perfectly in order to make this work. In order to get the prompts I want. Okay. Hit him hard. There you go. You got him. Heal up. Alright, we got guys on this side. Alright. I don't have any explosive arrows. There you go. Now I do. Lots of explosives all over the place. I like this. Who needs armor piercing? Nice. Bites the dust. Come on, man. It's two arrows to your head. I mean, I realize they're immortal, so, you know, they take a little bit more damage than everybody else. Okay. Thank you for coming around my side. Appreciate it. Alright. Okay. I need to heal. Healing. Done. Oh, man. Those explosive arrows. So, so good. I'm gonna love him, but here's some poison. That actually worked out much better. Yeah, the poison might actually be better. He's crippled. And he's dead. Okay, we got more trebuchet action. Is that what's happening right now? I need more of everything.
The Chamber of Souls is through that gate. Just need to find another trebuchet.
Oh, well, that was on my list of things to do anyway, so your interest and my interest totally aligned. Okay, well, I really like the explosive arrows. I think that's been doing great right now. So, if I can make more of those, that is not explosive arrows, that is poison. That is explosive arrows. There we go. So, they opened up a couple of doors for me here. I'm gonna go through this door just because. Okay, or there's nothing there. Alright. Very good of them to seal the way they came in behind them. These guys do the same thing, or can I actually get out this way? Oh, okay, I get it. This door opens up the other door and closes the one behind me. I suppose that makes sense on a tactical level.
You don't have much time, Lara. You must reach the source before them.
There's nothing more you can do. Get somewhere safe.
Not a chance. You need us as much as we need you. We survive together or we die alone. Now go.
So, this looks like explosive arrow time. Yep. Oh, right. I forgot about the cluster bombs. Kind of an important step there. Alright, well, we've... I mean, it's nice that we open this up, but we've already been down there. That doesn't help us. This might help. We've already been down here too. We want to open up that side. So the only way we can do that is by going around this way. And sure enough, there's rope for us to take. Let's do it. Yeah. There we go. Let's open up this shortcut. That'll help us get to the bonfire later. Or get from the bonfire to here later, either way. And X is gonna give it to you. There you go. Again, I keep thinking Monster Hunter and keep thinking I hit X to launch my rope up. That is totally not how it works.
Need to reach the top of the tower, but that ice is in the way.
Well, fortunately, you can swing this around pretty easily, I guess. Do it one more time, and... Oh no, actually, that'll just do it. No, not quite. Need to push it somehow. Oh, well, if you jump right onto it, that'll jam it into place, right? Yep, there you go. Okay, let's try to make this nice and easy. Keep them all green. You green. And then... you. One more. There. Right, that should be a nice, easy climb. And it's not letting up, but I'm assuming that since her hand is up, that still indicates that she knows where she needs to go. There you go. Yeah, it's a nice visual tell. It still doesn't light it up. It's not lighting that one at all, but that's okay. Whoa! Or we just die. Come on, that was a nice, easy fall. That does not seem like that would kill me. Just saying. Okay, did I just not set these up properly? And it seems like that's an obvious one. So is that. That might even be unnecessary, but I did it anyway. Yeah, all three of them are there. Okay. You know what? I will set this one up just to be on the safe side. Okay. Yeah, but if her hand wasn't up, I guess that indicates that she's not actually going to jump where I want her to. I really want your hand to go up, though, because... Okay, so I needed to double jump that time. I just need the green circle lit up so I know that you're going... There you go. I forgot I can move the camera. That's very still in me. Come on, Laura. I need you to move your hand so you show me that you know where we're going. You know we're going that way, right? Right? Apparently not, but it still worked. Okay. Assuming no one's actually manning this trebuchet, which is a little bit weird. I don't see anybody. So, yeah, we might be alone here. Alright, hop up and away then. Okay, so we need to light the signal flyer. We can do the other thing first if we need to. Nope, other way. There you go. It's kind of cool how much these mechanisms still work, though I guess one of the orders they were given was don't let the mechanisms fail to work. Okay, this first. There you go. Is there something wrong here? It's not...
Yes, I think it's a way to clear it.
Alright, what is in the way here? There's nothing there, but it looks like it might be in the front. Well, let's see. It is in the front. It's this right here. You gotta pull that clear from here, right?
I'm not strong enough.
Don't say that, Laura. Of course you're strong enough. You just don't have the right leverage. That's the problem. So, more than likely, we're supposed to tie it to something that will stay behind as we pull from it. That makes the most sense. So, that would be going from there. Yeah, that would work. How do we get over there? There's a jumping platform from there to here, not the other way around. Well, what we could do is move this platform over so the part sticking out. Yeah, that would work. Okay. Let's go back around this way. So we basically walk right up to this. There you go. Jump over here. And then we can use the leverage from this. Stick it in. There you go. Yeah, and then when we move this platform, that should just rip that blockage right out. Theoretically. Or it'll tear the rope, one of the two. Oh, there we go.
That worked. Now to take out that gate.
Well, first we gotta light the signal flare, then we'll take out the gate. There we go. Bombs away. They're really proud of that animation, you can tell. And they should be. That was a lot of fun. Alright. Roll your boat. No, roll your trebuchet. Doesn't scan this problem really. That's what we want. Bombs away. That almost looked like it was an impact on the arch. Kinda funny if it missed. Can you hit it again? Well, looks like I'm not gonna get a chance. Alright. Well, it's a good thing I lit the signal flares when I could, because that trebuchet is busted.
Almost through. Just one more shot.
Alright, so I need to hit it with that trebuchet. Alright, we can make that happen. Need to go down to the appropriate spot. It's a little bit longer episode than I meant to do here, but that's okay. Bounce. There you go. And run here. Oh, no. Bad. Didn't work. I just realized that I was supposed to turn it with the rope first. I was just trying to rush it down. Obviously, that's not going to work. Okay, let's try that again. Let's pin you there. Yeah, obviously, I was supposed to turn that. That makes the most sense now that I think about it. For like more than 2 seconds. There you go. Come over here, please. Thank you. Much appreciated. Now we go ahead and run through this. There we go. But I think they have better defenses, right? Well, they are a few centuries out of practice, to be fair. Alright, just scooch a little along here. They don't even see me anymore. It seemed like they would put them on their offensive, to be honest. Up here, we can bounce and they'll swing us around, maybe? Of course it does. Climb up. Man, they don't count on Lara the Acrobatic, for sure. Hello. Don't suppose you'd be interested in some fine wine? Huh. Looks like he doesn't like wine. To be fair, I never really cared for it myself. That's some serious ice blockage there. That can only point this one way. Yeah, that's gotta be another puzzle, right? It's gotta be. I just don't know what it is. I don't know what the answer is yet. I mean, I know that you need to swing this around. Oh, yeah. So you need to raise this up and swing this around. That's what I need to do. So, actually, I need to tie something very similar to that side so this can be even with it. Yep. Or I can just swing it into place. Actually, just swinging it into place would totally work, huh? If I jump from there onto this, that might swing it into place there. For the shot. Yeah, that might work. Okay, down here. That'll take us up. Yeah, we need to go all the way up. How do we go all the way up? That's a good question. Oh, can I just walk along the beam? Seems like that would really mess with the weight distribution, but depends on how heavy that thing is, right? Yeah, we might just be able to walk along the beam. Let's see if that works. Yep, if you run along the beam, you probably don't even need to run. Yeah, that's a really heavy thing. Okay, good to know. Okay, why am I here? Good question. Nobody really knows the answer to that. I guess because you're supposed to tie this to this.
This should balance the arm.
Yep, that's what I thought. Alright, so that does that. Then if I'm able to pull this away from it, I should raise it up a little bit. There you go. Now go back over this way. You begin. Oh, actually, I need to fill that with water, don't I? Yeah, because right now it's not balancing shit right now. Okay, heave this around then. Ho! Because that's what I said was heave, so obviously the next one's ho. And then do that again. That should... No, won't actually get filled with water. Not yet. Alright. One more time. Oh! There you go. That went a little
bit too far. It's not holding water.
Alright, well, I could tie it down, but that's kind of defeats the point. It's not holding water. Let's see. And there's a rope there that indicates I'm supposed to do something else with it. But yeah, if it's not going to hold water, that's the problem.
That lever on the bucket might close the draining mechanism.
Oh, am I just supposed to pull on it? That's it. Okay, that was just silly is what that was. Or I'm just silly. One of those. Anyway, time to heave-ho again, because we got to do it all the way around. And... Oops, that was a mistake. Oh! And... Heave! Heave, I said. Heave! There you go. And finally, of course... Ho ho ho, Merry Christmas. Nope, not Merry Christmas. Hey, Happy New Year then. Happy Holidays? There you go. That did it. Might have even overdone it. Okay, so... How does this work? Magic, I think, is the answer.
The siege of Katesh must have lasted for months.
So now we need to jump on it to dislodge it, and I think we can do that... I would not want to do it from this direction. That would be bad. I think we can do... Yeah, from this direction, we'd smash this into the ice. That would be definitely bad. Don't do that. We want to be over on that side. Okay, that worked. Thank goodness for the rope. So otherwise, that wouldn't have worked. Okay, should we be able to catch onto this? No, probably not. Okay, let's try that again, but without the owl. Can you actually get up here? Can't really see what I'm doing. There you go. Maybe I need to use the rope again? Yeah, because that seems to be the only reason why I caught up with this. So probably the same applies here. Use the climbing rope? No, it did not work. I think it's positioned correctly, right? I think it's positioned to take the ice out, yeah? I just need to be a little bit higher to catch that. Or the bucket needs to be a little bit less full. A little bit less full bucket might actually be true, but I don't want to empty the whole thing. Yeah, that's going to be a problem. Do I want to swing this into position? Seems wrong, but... I could swing it from... I don't know if that's actually going to work. We swing this all the way around. I really think I was right. I think I need to like empty the bucket halfway or something. That seems ridiculous, though. How do you time that properly? It really seems like if it's open or not, it's a binary state. Yeah, swinging around didn't help. If we need to lower the bucket, or like half. Nope, that was more than half. That was all of it. That was like the bottom of the bucket fell out. Oh, but now it's lined up correctly. Right? I think so, yeah. There you go. It was. See how we did it in the bucket. That's what it was.
That did it.
Okay. So now we can use the trebuchet, we can get the hell out of here. All's good in the world. For now, though, thank you guys for watching. This has been Rise of the Tomb Raider.
The Mongol armies must have been completely buried in the ice before they could invade the main city.
This has been Rise of the Tomb Raider on PC Universe, your PC Universe 2, and I'll see you guys next time.